Hey guys, it's Noah. I want to pray and get into this word. Father, bridle my tongue, speak through me from the spirit, not from the flesh. We thank you for this time. We thank you for this day. Thank you. We lift this day up to you. We commit it into your hands. Speak through me from the spirit. He said, you'll see a bear for confirmation on this, that this is for you, okay? He told me that there's somebody that watches this. He's about to turn the light off on you. He said, no, I'm about to turn the light off. And he doesn't want that. I don't want that. It's not too late for you. I don't care anything. And whatever this stuff is, there's always a way, right? Whatever you think you've done, even the wax, I don't know. He's saying just, it's that he will make a way. But you need to come home to him. I was thinking about this time. I'm sorry, I'm processing some stuff in my, like, what he's trying to say to me. Father, give me direction. I was just sitting here. We did some quick cleaning. Like, we did the floors and vacuum mopped and all that other stuff, right? I'm sitting here mopping the floor. I really enjoy doing floors. My mom made me do floors like crazy when I was a kid. She was the floor Nazi, like straight up. She would like, she'd find like one little hair. She'd be like, you did a half-assed job, Noah. Like, straight up. But I'd be like, what? They're clean. They looked clean to me. But I was a kid too, trying to go out and play, right? And I was using the mop in here. It was the same spinner mop. I love those mops. They're good. Coming from a floor guy, that's a good review, right? And I was just remembering how I got two precious years with my dad of us both being in sobriety, okay? I'd go over and we'd hang out all day. And we just spent time together. I wasn't trying to sell him the gospel. I wasn't trying to do anything like that. I was just hanging out with my dad. Sober. Me and him. We were both hurt. For a lot of years, we were hurt. And I wouldn't trade those years that I got to hang out with my pop for anything. We'd eat pizza. I'd do his floors. We'd hang out. He'd watch NASCAR at full volume. Like, it was just good. And God is offering that to somebody. And I don't know. And I don't know who needs to hear this, but dang, man. Drugs and alcohol steal so much from your life. Some kid needs their dad or their mom. And I got that for 2 years. I got that. We both got it. And here's the other thing. When my dad got free, when that genetic curse or whatever that was, that it was a familiar curse, was broken off by my dad getting serious. Within 2 years, I got sober, right? And then we got 2 years of sobriety together, where he was clear in his thinking and he was lucid. He's offering that to somebody. And I don't know who this is for, but man, he's got his arm out to you. Just get serious. some kid needs their mom or dad. Don't get the light turned out on you. I remember when I first got sober, I was in my apartment and there was this song. It was like, I'm gonna leave the light on. It was like a rap song. I don't know. It was kind of like the, I don't know who it was. It was like an old, like they sounded kind of like that band Rehab or whatever. And he's like, I'm gonna leave the light on to show you that there's still some hope. I'm gonna leave the light on. And I had just had a near-death experience. I saw, you know, hell. And the light was still on. If this hits you, that means it's not too late. And you're gonna see a bear. I don't know what that means. Please come home. Get washed by the blood. It's not too late. I love you. I don't want anybody going to hell. It's so bad. God bless you guys. God bless you guys.